Hey everybody, welcome to episode 103. Today I'm going to try something different and see what happens here. Like I said, I kind of prepared for it a little bit, but I'm going to kind of try to, you know, fly in the seat of my pants here and see if I can pull this off. And bear with me, I haven't really played too many things in front of an audience outside of like my son or, you know, or my friend or whatever. So I might butcher this a few times trying to put this down on the video, but I think I'll get more comfortable as long as I do it. Just like me talking to the camera, essentially just talking to myself. It took me a while to kind of get a little more comfortable with that, but I'm going to try to do some stuff. And what I want to do with this is I want to show you, like I said, and I'll probably get lots of guff by people that are, you know, trained musicians or people who are a lot more well in the know than I am. People say, oh, you're doing this all wrong, right? You know what I say? I don't care about any of that stuff, because you know what? I don't, at this day and age, I don't care if I'm doing things wrong. I don't care if, I don't want to, again, I don't want to tell you that this is the way to do it, so I don't want to mislead somebody who's learning to play guitar or something. I say, do the traditional route. Listen to the people who know what they're talking about, whether it's the teachers, like my son takes guitar lessons every week. And I tell him stuff here and there, but, you know, I do, he even barks at me. He's like going, I don't like the way you do this. It's so weird. And I go, that's because I do it my own way. And I realize a lot of things I do my own way. I rarely ever pay attention to any techniques or discipline or whatever. But this is the way I've pretty much done it most of my life. And I've taken some lessons here and there and blah, blah, blah. And I've this and studied that, but when it really comes down to it, this is how I approach learning a song. And here's the thing, I would much prefer to play something original. And you know, I went through all my recording phases and recording, you know, my own original stuff. You know, I didn't pay attention, I mean, I paid attention to my things that I liked, but you could definitely hear the influences of things in what I was playing. But at the end of the day, I just did my own thing and see how it came out, you know, and I'd play it for somebody and say, hey, what do you think about this? And I'd play on the tapes, you know, we used to record on a 4-track and then be like, this sounds pretty good, you know, or this doesn't sound that great. So this is how I do for a hobby now. This is not a profession. I don't do this for a profession. I don't aspire to do it for a profession. I'm, you know, showing you guys and, you know, trying to get this on YouTube is about the closest thing I'm going to aspire to doing anything professionally if I ever monetize the channel. So again, my disclaimer is listen to the pros, listen to people who know what they're talking about, but this is just an alternative way you can look at learning music. And it's not really that far from how you really do it. It's just that I like to deconstruct things. I don't want to just play a song verbatim, you know, or mechanically. I want to look at what's the parts of the song, what the song's made of. You know, I might take it apart a little bit. You know, I might change this around here. I might change the key, change this. Play it to however I feel comfortable playing it, and then and see how it comes out on the other end, you know. So that's what I'm going to do here. I've played the song before, and I've already done the work, essentially, for this song. But I'm going to do, I'm going to show you faithfully, because it's a nice, slow, easy one, and I'm pretty comfortable playing most of it. So, you know, and I'll even sing a little bit of it too. I don't have the nice microphone. The guitars are not going to be plugged in. I've got an acoustic classical, and I've got my bass, which I'll play the pick so you can hear it a little bit more. I don't want to plug it in. It might be a little too loud for the apartment. So, kind of show you how I've been looking at this song. And I've been kind of, you know, I do this with a bunch of songs. I have like a lot of songs going on at once. And I kind of do whatever I'm in the mood for. I'll flip over to whatever and kind of see what's going on here. Or I'll try to find something new that I want to learn, you know, or just teach myself or whatever. Or, like I said, or just come up with, maybe it spawns something new. Like, you're like, you know what? I'm really not getting this song. And it's starting to sound like crap. But I like certain parts, and I think I can pull off certain parts pretty well. So, hey, I'm going to take that part, mix it up a little bit, and maybe I'll try to come up with something off of that original, right? And then if you want to, you can record that down. I haven't been doing that because I don't really have the best recording capabilities at the moment outside of something like this, you know, or just recording it, you know, just kind of, you know, just playing, you know, just hitting record and just recording the sound. I got the interface, like I said, but I haven't really plugged it in and done that. I don't have Pro Tools. I don't have, you know, I had Cakewalk for a while. I still technically have it, but I just, Cakewalk just irritated me, so I kind of stopped using that. So I'm going to take you through the absolute beginning of how I kind of arrived at this. First thing I want to say is this is what happened. So I'll take the class of the guitar right here. Right? Remember, I'm a bass player. I guess I play everything, but I mean, I primarily like to play bass, but I like to play guitars here and there, you know, so I can figure things out. And I by no means am an intermediate guitar player. I'm like a beginner level guitar player, if that. I mean, I know stuff from the other instrument translated over, but like I said, I'm not, and there's no bells and whistles here. There's no sweeping, picking, and all that insanity. I mean, this is pretty much bare bones what I know. But like I said, when I look at a song, and I'll go online, you know, obviously to find the chords and what, and see what's going on with the song, so I can take a visual look at it. Because I find visually looking at it and kind of analyzing it a little bit, every little bit you do, every little thing you do, every little thing you do is magic. Now, every little thing you do, it just starts getting it in here, and then once it's in here, then it starts to get in here, and once it's in here and here, then you pretty much got most of it down. So everything you can do, like I said, just listening to a song, looking at a song, looking up the song, you know, looking up how the song's structured, yada yada, looking at the sheet music, looking at tablature, looking at all of it, right? If you got time, and like I said, this is a hobby, something you want to do as a pastime, I say just take your time. Songs aren't going anywhere. Hopefully your guitars and your equipment's not going anywhere. Hopefully you're not going anywhere. Just sit back and try to figure it out. So first thing we're going to do is how I arrived at it. I was playing something. I play a lot of these because it's a classical. Because there's a lot of open chords like a B. I can't do the full B because I'm just not comfortable chord switching. G's are easy, D's are easy, C's are easy, right? Going to certain chords like B is a hard one, always, and F's a hard one, or even F sharp or C sharp. I'll use that, and I'll just do that kind of claw thing, which obviously that's why I picked a classical guitar, because a classical guitar is just playing with your fingers. I mean, sure, yeah, you can play with a pick, but playing with your fingers, I find nice, slow, easy way to kind of, you know, work on things. So I always play that D a lot, right? And then I was playing a song, can't remember which one it was a Beach Boys song, that Sloop Up, Sloop the John B, so I can't remember what that song is called, Sloop something, John B, Sails, NASA, whatever, that song. And this D, a lot of people do this with a D, they'll play that, I think it's a sus, D sus 2, I believe, but I'm probably wrong on that. That's what I wrote it down as. I might be wrong. A lot of people do that as an accent when they're playing a D. They do a lot of that. I think John Denver even does that in the leaving on that Jared plane. I think he does that when he comes to the D. He plays it on a 12 string, but then he does it. But I noticed I'm like that. What's that sound like? And it took me a little while of that, just playing that until I'm like, what the hell does that sound like? And then I realized, oh, it sounds like Faithfully by Journey. And so then what do you think? Let's look up Journey and see what's going on here. So I did get this after the fact, by the way. I went down to Herder Music, downtown Bay City, with my son one day, and I was just going through the... It kind of reminds me of Evola Music. It used to be in Winchester Mall, so I kind of went through and I was looking, and I came across this, and it was like $12, $15 or whatever, and I was like, hey, I said to my son, I said, would you want, because he loves Journey, I said, do you need this? He's like, what is it? And I go, well, it's piano, it's got the chords for guitar, it's got piano, and it's got the lyrics. And he's like, oh, maybe, but it's like, I like to attack a song first, not first, but I mean, I like to attack a song if I have this at my disposal, I don't need to know the guitar tablature because I'm not going to play it exactly how the guitar tablature is, right? I just want to immediately see what, and you'll see it there, what are the chords? You don't even have to have a diagram. Just tell me the letter, right? Is it a G? Okay. Is it an E minor? Is it a C? Right? And they usually have it, obviously, like regular sheet music corresponding with the lyrics. So, you know, like when you're on like Highway Run, right? What's that note? When you're on Highway Run and Faithfully. So you're like here, what's it? I'm on the inner way. Any way you want it. Any way you want. Oh, plus when I start singing, trust me, I can't sing, but I'll give it my best shot. Okay, here, Faithfully. So Highway, at the end of the second bar, it's Highway, what? Highway Run. Okay, Runs right on a C. So they've got it on a C. And again, I tried this differently before that, but when I saw that, I was like, Highway Run. Okay. Run into the midnight sun. I like it, but then it goes into a couple of chords that I can't play very well. And I was like, let's find the chord. This is what I do. I'll find a song I want to play, find a song that I like. I'll see that either I lucked out right off the bat and go, oh, it's got those four chords that I already know, right? Or I'll go, how can I transpose this and see what chords all of them that I do know, and maybe if there's one sussy one, no pun intended, I can figure it out. You know, I can fake it. So I'll do that. So the first thing I did for this song specifically is that I wanted to know what the chords were, right? And ironically, like I said, they got it Highway Run. They're putting it, it's a C. I guess that's the key of C. Again, I'm not, that part, I always got to look up. It's like I always assume if I'm starting on a note like C, that's in the key of C. And then I'll go through the notes. I go, okay, those are all in the C major scale. So that's a C major, key of C major. I'm totally off. And I'm like, all right, well, okay. So I don't know what I'm talking about. But sometimes I nail it like, woo, yeah, I knew what I was talking about. So what I do from there is I usually go to, and I'll show you a couple of websites here. First thing I usually do, sorry, this is all my, from my junk, or my music file here. I already pulled up some of these files here, is I'll go to, there's Songster. So we can look, let's look at Songster first before we go over to Guitar, Ultimate Guitar, which are pretty much the two biggest ones that most people use. You can use them for free for the most part. I don't have memberships to them, so some of the functionality is kind of limited to me. But again, songster.com, it's with two R's, songster2R's.com. If you want to use them, if you're into guitar, you already know this, but go to them, give them some love, or go to Guitar Ultimate Guitar and give them some love, right? And I'll go to them next, but let's look at the journey here. And you can bring up like the YouTube music file here if you want to play with it. Again, I don't know if this is going to get a copyright strike because I'm not really going to play much of the song. I'm going to play it myself. And again, I'm playing it off. So I don't know if it's going to still be considered a copyright strike, but I'm just going to use it sparingly. So I'm not going to play the regular song, you know, the actual recording of it. Again, if you want to do that, just go on YouTube or go on here. Do the same thing. Now you can also hit play and it'll play this out in real time. Now if you have a membership, you can slow it down and do all kinds of funky jazz, but I don't. So I just look at what it is, and sometimes I'll play it just to hear it. And sometimes it's got a drum track on it. They're all MIDI tracks. You'll see here, and again, this is on bass. So this is kind of where I'm going to in a very long kind of way, as far as, because remember, I play bass mostly, but I use the guitar as a tool to learn songs or to deconstruct songs, and then I can take it to the bass. I mean, sometimes I can do the same thing on a bass right off the bat, but a lot of times I don't. So I'm just curious for the bass, though. There's that fancy cataxin. So they've got it starting off on Highway, let's use a pick so it's a little louder. Highway Run. Really? Doesn't sound right. Highway Run Into the, where's it go? Into the midnight sun. Wheels go round and round of my mind. I'll sing it better later. I'm just kind of showing you that. That's what they've got here with the little fills and everything like that. I'm just looking at basically the chords at this point. And I'm like, but when have you play it, you're like, that's what it is. For some reason, it still doesn't sound right. Remember, I'm going off that D chord with that D sus 2. I believe it's a D sus 2. And I was like, I like that. Going from the D to the D sus 2, then back. I like that little transition, because that's what made me think of it in the first place. I'm like, I want to try to keep that in, because I can play that. So let's try to keep that in the song. So we're going to have to transpose it at some point. So here's what we do. Now, luckily, when I went to Ultimate Guitar, now here's how you just go to Ultimate Guitar, go to, let's just type in Faithfully, and I'll show you how, where I usually go to here, Journey Faithfully at. Okay. All right, so you've got, like, the official, which you have to pay for, and then you've got Chords, Tab, Guitar Pro, you have Bass Tabs, Ukulele. I just go to Chords almost every time. Even though I'm gonna learn some of the stuff on bass or guitar, I usually don't go to those because the way they have the tabs structured out, they're really ugly looking, and I don't like it. So what I do is I go to here, and I usually click on the version 2, because version 1's okay. Again, official, you need a membership for a little green thing there. But I'm gonna go to just the regular Faithfully. Now, what do they have it in? Is the first. So Highway Run, they've got it in the B as well. So just like, no, they had it in C. Wait a minute, where am I at? The book had it going to C. Highway Run on C. The songster had it correct, go to the B, Highway Run, and that's how this version 1 is, right? So you look through the chords and you go, okay, Highway Run. All right, and then E is pretty simple, into the midnight sun, you're going to G sharp sus 4, but I don't think, is that in the sun? That's that little augmented part. So like again, right off the bat for me, I was like, oh, this looks confusing. I don't know if that's right. So you can transpose it by hitting transpose, and you'll see what it does is you can transpose it. So let's take it up to a D. Right? That makes more sense. Gets the D, then the B, then the G. It's like, okay, I can do that. But I don't like the way this is laid out, right? So I noticed that there were other versions. So I said, hey, let's take a look at the other versions and see. And oddly enough, this version, which is on C, which actually normally goes to D, but it didn't this time, is this one here. And I was like, okay, so again, there's that sus. So I just do those, and I think it's D sus 2, because sus 4 would be, no, I can't remember what sus 4 is. I'm probably wrong on that. I just, a D plus whatever that is. I could figure it out if I could just go through the scale, but I'm not going to waste my time doing that. So I was like, okay, so I like the D, and like, Highway Run. That sounds cool because it sounds like the keyboard. And that's the other thing. You think about the other instruments that are playing, not just the guitar, not just the bass. Think about the other guitar. You know, you look up the keyboard, it's like piano. Or when it does the synthesizer. Or is it the guitar? In the one solo part. I like that. So I'm like, okay, I'll keep that in there. Then I'll go to the D, to the B. It's like, the B's not there. Okay. So we got Highway Run into the midnight sun. Oh, I can still hit that. I like that. I can still hit that, too. So it's almost like a descending. It's almost like your chords are descending, but you're doing a melody over here. So you're kind of keeping that as your melody chord, your melody note. And then, so you went from the D to my B, which is just a kind of a modified B. But but I can go to that really easy with my pinky. So, okay. And where am I going here? Wheels, wheels go round and round on my mind. Back to the D. Okay, I can play that. Let's hope it doesn't get any harder than that. But I could play that. That's simple. Let's do this. And then we're going to go to what now? The back to the D? But I like this. I was like, I want to add this into it. Sending all my love along the wire. I like that. That sounds cool. I like that. Like, again, I'm deconstructing the song. It's not how it's played. It's not how it's played in the recording. I don't think they've ever played it that way, even live. Maybe somebody else has in a bar somewhere. Somebody covered it. But to me, that's... I have never heard it like that, but I like that. Here's the other thing, is I keep playing that to get that. This is how I try to in-tune my voice to the music. Because like I said, I have a terrible voice. I took a little test scale. My voice is like dead mid-range. I've got, and it doesn't have very much range. I can't even go to the top of the mid-range, and I can't even go to the lower end of the mid-range. I'm like stuck with like maybe 3 or 4 different notes that I can kind of hit in that mid-range. It's dead because I haven't trained my voice, you know, so I don't know. But highway run, it might sound different to you because you're outside of my head, but in my head that sounds good. And with the guitar, another reason I like the acoustic is it reverberates on your chest and your stomach, so when you're singing, I mean, it's everywhere, just reverberating through your body. And I can kind of use that to intone to that note, right? How I run into the midnight sun, wondering where I am, lost without you. Perfect. So we're going to stay with that D. Or I guess it's the key of D, is it? It usually tells you if you put that on there. But I think it's D minor, I think, is the key that it's in. And is that a D minor or is that a D major? I always thought that was a D major. Again, I'm not a huge guitar player, so I don't know all these exactly. So now we've got that down, right? So let's go through and let's try to sing that part, how they've got it. Just the first verse and see if we can figure that part out. Now, before I do that, I'm going to show you what I did. So this is kind of complicated. Obviously, with the guitar here and all this just visual noise just kind of gets in my way. I want to ignore all this stuff, right? So I copied and pasted and just kind of rewrote it myself into a Word document. And I just did this. Make it really simple. And if you want to, you can even blow this up. You're going to eventually have to scroll at some point, but if you want to do a page width, now look at it, it's way up there. I can really see it now. I kind of know the song now, so I don't look at it as much. But at first, and I'll even print it out big. I printed it out here just off of my Word file, and I keep it in this binder. But I printed out, like I was working on a Blue Oyster Cult song, and I had 5 sheets spread out doing Vengeance the Pact. I was playing it on the bass, and I was like, I can barely see this. Because I can't see far away, but when I put my glasses on to see that far away, then I can't see what I'm doing if I have to look over at the fretboard, right? Because I don't bifocal, so what I did is I just printed that up big so I could see, like an old person, which I am, so I could see it, right? Now I did the D sus 2, the D sus 4, put it in there. Again, I don't know if that was right or wrong, but I just did that for visual reference just so I know I'm going to do that. That thing and that little accent. So me writing it wrong is my visual cue to see how I think. I think weird. This is what happens when you grow up with learning disabilities. Anyways, so we're back to the D. And we're going to do that 2-4 times. So, but I'm not really going to do it 4 times. I'm going to run through. I'm going to go do the... to the B. To the G. Right? Okay. So, I do that 4 times for this song. But let's go to the verse just to save some time here. So let's go to Highway Run into the midnight sun. Wondering how wheels go round and round on my mind. Restless hearts sleep alone tonight. Sending all my love along the wire. Right? Right? So now let's go to the chorus. They say that the... going to the G now. Say that the road ain't no place to start a family. Here comes that. Right down the line, it's been you and me. Sound weird. Loving the music man ain't always what it's supposed to be. Uh-oh, what do I do now? It's an A. Oh, girl, you stand by me. Let's try that again. Loving the music man ain't always what it's supposed to be. I don't even have that written down. I just want to do it anyways. Oh, girl, stand by me. Uh-oh. I'm forever yours. I love that E, F sharp, G. Or the... I love that. If I can get that into a song, I'll transpose it just so I can do the... either... or the... I love that. So... I'm forever yours, faithfully. I love it. Like I said, so I was like, that's how I want to play the song. And of course, you can go back and learn the other learns, you know, like Circus Life. Circus line under the big top world. That's way off. We all need some clowns to make us smile through space and time. Always enough to show. Wondering where I am, lost without. And being a party is it down this love affair. Two strangers fall in love again. I get the joy of rediscovering you. Oh girl, you stay. No. Yeah, yeah. I didn't boldface the F my F sharp minor there. I'm forever yours, faithfully. I'm all going to the na 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 na. Okay, so that's what I've got for the song, and I wrote that down for the whole song. Practiced it a bunch of times. You know, I played it for my son. He just rolled his eyes. You're not playing it the right way. And I played it for, like, my family members and stuff around Christmas last year. Or not Christmas. I remember my aunt was here. Sometime in the beginning of the year. And it was that was my birthday, right around my birthday. That's what it was. In July. And they thought it was okay. So, you know, they knew what the song is, obviously, so I like that, and that's what I like to do. So I like to find a song that I like, obviously, and then if I can't play it how they play it, I don't want to play it how they do. I want to play it my own way, so I'll deconstruct it and try to figure out a way to do that. So when we came to the bass, not that this is a heavy, heavy bass guitar track, which it's not, I also kind of do the same thing. Now, if you've got the chords, and this is how I learn a lot of bass lines too, unless there's a specific riff that I need to have in it, like that Vengeance the Pack by Blue Oyster Cult. So if you need to know that little riff, which is where a chord is, you got to learn that little riff. I mean, some of those things you have to kind of know, or God of Thunder by Kiss. I just figured that out last night. I was watching something. I was like, hey, I might be able to figure that out. And of course, he doesn't play it like that on the bass. He plays it a little bit simpler. That's the way it's played on the guitar. I'll get to that later. So I come to the bass for this. I've got this little handy dandy thing, and it's not so handy and it's not so dandy. It's got the bass chords for all the chords, and I guess it's, obviously it's the notes that are in that specific chord. So if you're playing like a C minor 7, right, you want to know the specific notes on a bass that are in there, starting with the root, you know, going into the, majors. You go through the major scale till you get to the chords that are in that C major scale. So if you got like the C, start with the C. All right. Right, so all of those notes, not all of those notes, but most of those notes are in this this little chord. So these aren't scales, these are chords. I thought it would be helpful at first, like, oh, okay, so I'll be able to just handy quick reference, look down and see, oh, those are the notes in the scale. I don't really need to know the scale. But the thing is, the scales, even if I played like an E minor scale, right? All the modes, or whatever they call them, the little patterns, they're all kind of the same. You might have to change it around a little bit if you're on different strings. But so long as you find the root. So there's an E major scale. So what were we going to? The C? Back to the high C, right? That's all you really need to know, because really all you need to know is the root, the C, the root, the root. Right, you need to know the third, so it's 1, 2, 3, and then the fifth, 4, 5, and then you can even get the octave in there. Sorry. Sorry, I'm still a little rusty doing this in front of an audience. Right, if you want to know the root, the third, the fifth, the octave. But just like so when it comes to like electric guitar and distortion, I pretty much just know your power chords, which is pretty much, you know, your E5, which is your fifth. So you got your, let's say you go to the E. Right? E, you go to your fifth. And then if you want to add the octave, you can make it a little more fuller, which is almost pretty much a full bar chord, but not. And that's how I pretty much, when I crank the distortion up and I want to play stuff, I'll play those. Or I'll do like in that God of Thunder song, he uses just the, he plays the fifth and the high octave without even playing the original root. And it kind of makes it easier. You can slide and bend. It freely seems like he does that a lot. So, where were we at? So let's go back to Faithfully. Which time again? All right, we're doing good on time. So we're at D. So we're like, highway run until into the midnight sun. I'll look at the lyrics right there. And the wheels go round and round on my mind. Okay, that's pretty simple and boring, right? The A. Okay. do that a few times, just so you, like I said, get it into your head, the chords and the chord progression. Get all of that into your head, even if you're just playing the single notes, right? Just sit there and go, highway run into the midnight sun. Ooh, where am I at? The wheels go round and round on my mind. Restless heart, sleep alone tonight. Wondering, was it wondering where it was? No, sending all my love along the wire. Or to the A, right? Okay, it sounds boring. If you got a cool lick in there and you're used to doing the thirds and the fifths and you got some cool little pattern that fits into that, because remember, you don't want it to not fit the song. The easiest way for that is either just do the, just play the power chord and just do it, just pick it, interpick it. Or just do the octave. So you can do, let's do, highway run into the midnight sun. Wheels go round and round on my mind. Now you don't have all the extra notes that you do with the guitar, so you gotta kinda have to use your imagination. Let's see where he goes. Restless heart. Wait. Sleep. Where are we at? Restless heart, sleep alone tonight. Sending all my love along the Hawaii. And then you can even go to the other part and go, they say that the road ain't no place to start a family. Right down the line, no, right down the line, it's been you and me. Love and the music, man, ain't always what it's supposed to be. Oh, girl, stand by. Out of tune. I'm forever yours. Faithfully. So just kind of sit back. You know, get stoned if you want to, but I don't do that. But anyways, sit back. Shut your eyes. And just kind of just noodle around. Find where, maybe you find another note you like, it's in there. It fits because it's in key, you know, it's in the scale. And just work around this. Like I said, this is how I approach music today. And, you know, because it's just a hobby for me. I look at things, and I don't do everything the exact same way. Like, so this song, I approached a lot differently than I learned something Vengeance the Pact. I don't know if you know the song. It's a song by Blue Oyster Cult off the Fire of Unknown Origin album. It's cool. It's the one about Tarna from the movie, you know, from the heavy metal sequence with Tarna. It wasn't in the movie. It was supposed to be, but it was axed, you know, at the last minute. But, sorry, I got all my notes in the back. But, yeah. So I printed it out big, because, like I said, so I could at least sprawl this out. Now, I just put I just printed that out in letter form, you know, the E minor, C, G, E minor, C, G, E minor. So that, I had to learn the riff to that, because if you play that without the riff, it doesn't sound right. Right, then when he goes into the verse, that, see them standing in the foothill, waiting for the hill. So you have to know that riff. It pretty much has, I mean, you have to play it on the up here for one part, and then does it. That's pretty much the only riffy part you need to know in the song. There's kind of a hard part where after that part it breaks into the. See, I just screwed that up. Let's see. You don't have to play it that fast, but it sounds cooler that fast. I think you can just go. You can do that if you want. There's a certain part where it kind of speeds up there. The tempo speeds up, and you kind of have to play it a little quick. But it's a cool song. It's got a lot of different time changes and a lot of different tempo changes in it. So it's just a fun little song to play. And when I got the album, the actual physical album, I was like, oh, I got to learn that song. I really like that. Because I knew... The Soul Survivor off that. I learned that. I'm funny. I woke up one. This is back at the trailer park when I was a kid. I woke up one morning and I could hear somebody playing that song like three trailers over. Because remember, trailers are crepe paper thin. I could hear somebody playing. I was like, are they playing Soul Survivor by Fire of Unknown Origin? I could hear it. Somebody's stereo like three trailers away. And then all of a sudden they went to the next song. I learned this is the whole album. And but that dude. That stuck in my head, and I was like, oh, I gotta learn that. So I literally reached over, grabbed the bass, pulled it up. I'm just like, all right, I gotta put the song on. So I put the song on. I'm just like, I've got that part. No. Oh. Ba, 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 ba. Oh, and then I learned how to play that. So, but it's cool. The other riff to Vengeance isn't far from that, but it's a little different. Again, it's kind of an you probably don't know that song very much, but it's off that album. Obviously, nobody listened to my Blue Oyster Cult video, so there's probably very few Blue Oyster Cult fans. It's all about the Kiss. Oh yeah, back to the Kiss. So, I took my son's guitar, his electric guitar, and I just looked up on Songster, and I wanted to know, I'll just pull it up. I wanted to know God of Thunder. I wanted to know the guitar part because I was considering buying a Les Paul copy, and I still found one. There's an Ace. I'll show you it sometime. There's an Ace Frehley. There's two Ace Frehley signature model copies from a Chinese knockoff company. I was like, ooh, those are really cool, but they're a little out of my price range still, and I don't really feel like ordering off of AliExpress or to some extent. Getting a guitar off eBay. I like Amazon because if it's effed up, I can just return it. And you can get the other, which are a lot cheaper, the other Les Paul copies. And they have a Cherry Sunburst, which is essentially, you know, his Budokan. Well, it doesn't have the three custom pickups. The other one does, but sorry, I'm going off on that one. I want to keep this little on base here. So let's go to search. Let's go to God of Thunder. Where's Thunder? Let's see. God of Thunder. Here it is. And then let's take it off bass. Let's go to, how do we do this? Over here to the little guitar. You can do this as part of the free part, but go to the Paul Stanley guitar. Yeah, just to get the rhythm. I'm not worried about the what do you call it? It's the leads or anything. Because I'm not gonna play the leads, but I'll let my son play the leads. But anyways, I was like, so what's this all about? What's this song? I see that. See the open up here. You go. Right. Simple. And then I was like, okay, so let's learn the this other part. And again, here we go. He's on the fifth fret, which is a, what are we on here? It's a G. And then he's he's adding this fifth on the G string here, right? And you're getting that fifth, but you're getting it with the high octave instead of going to low. So otherwise, you'd go to the, it's actually a C chord, but you're doing it this way. And then if you bend that, or if you do that with the double sevens, as you can see there, so it goes. There's a little bit of a bend there. And you bend that up, it's like, oh, that sounds really cool. It's like, oh, I definitely want to get one of those Les Pauls and try to start learning some of this Kiss music on that. I mean, like, so that's like, you know, you guys know all too well, that's like a lifelong dream for me to play Kiss songs on the, on even on guitar or the bass, and that's like lifelong dream right there, fulfilled. So I thought to myself, well, what is Gene playing the bass? And obviously we can check it out, but he doesn't play that. But I thought, hey, it's more fun to play that. I want to play the guitar part just on the bass, which instead of doing those notes with the double things, I'll just do the single note but still bend it, right? So I like, that's like, oh, I got my switch pick, so I need my harder pick. So like, all right, let's play that instead, because I think he's just doing, what's he just doing? Again, this is if this is correct, but the Gene Simmons bass line, he's just going. He's just on the seven. Actually, he's tuned a step down, so. Is he all the way down? Let's see what, so that G becomes a. So what are we doing now? We tuned, we're going down, yeah, one step down. So we're just playing a step down. That doesn't sound right with the. Something sounds off there. But anyways, but as you can see, he's just playing a few. I mean, he does a couple of dun-dun-dun. He does a couple of, bends and stuff here and there. But it's kind of, eh. So I just like to mimic the Paul Stanley guitar part, which is the bass. Just sounds better. Oh, there we go. And then what's the other part that goes into the? See, that's what I love doing that. I like playing not the right stuff. I like to play whatever I find the best, and that's how I kind of go approach it. So I just started that last night, so I'm going to get more into that, try some effects and stuff, kind of get that bass, you know, Gene Simmons-y kind of bass thing. Maybe I'll tune down a half, are they tuned? Yeah, they're all tuned down. So right, so they're playing it differently. I was playing it wrong, because you got to use the open strings. Okay, so I'll tune it down the half step on all strings and then try it like that. There's a lot of Ghost songs I've been playing on the bass that are all tuned down a half step or even a whole step. So we'll try it there and see if it sounds better, which it probably would, because it's got that, you know, has that. I mean, that's the song he breaks into after his big spit and blood solo. So, you know, so I'll work on that. And I'd like to learn it on guitar, too. So, like I said, I'd like to get one of those copy Les Pauls. That would be pretty sweet. I'm thinking about getting one. No, I don't know if I'm going to get one yet. Now, of course, obviously, if I get one, I'll do an unboxing. I was thinking about getting the Cataxin version of my bass on guitar and get a matchy-match set. But you know what? I love the feel of those Les Paul, or a real Les Paul specifically, but I can't afford that. So I'd like to get a copy Les Paul for, you know, cheap guitar. Because, like, again, I'm not a guitar player, and I don't aspire to become a great one. I just want something to noodle on, to screw around with, and so, you know, what better way than buy a cheap guitar?
I mean, this was cheap. You know, even this baby, this thing was cheap.
This is a Yamaha, but I mean, it was like $150. I think I had a coupon on Amazon. I think I got it for like $110. I mean, this is a classical guitar. I mean, it sounds fine to me. You know, I didn't even tune this when I picked. This thing's been sitting in the gig bag for a couple of days. I didn't even tune this up, and it's still in tune. So, tells you this is pretty good quality. But yeah, I mean, like I said, that I've got that Spectre that's 20 years old now. That's the nicest thing that I own. Otherwise, I just buy cheap stuff. And again, I also suggest, here, I'll put myself back on the main camera. I also suggest you do the same thing. If your intention is just to F around, right? If you just want to screw around, you don't want to become, you know, Mr. Guitar or Mr. Music. And, you know, you just want to play enough stuff just to have fun. Bedroom jam. Just sit around bedroom jam. Figure things out. And my son's he plays saxophone at school, and he's an amazing guitar player already at 11 years old. I said, you wouldn't believe the stuff. I think he needs to stop learning so many solos and learn the meat and potatoes of songs, which he does. Because he's the piano. He plays the key. Got his keyboard out there in his little, you know, area out there. And he plays the piano, does great stuff. He is technically a musical prodigy. And, you know, if I've ever seen a musical prodigy, he is a musical prodigy. And obviously, he gets a lot of that stuff. Not that I'm a prodigy, but I mean, he gets the passion for it, and like the, you know, the whatever, the drive from me. And his mother can play, so he gets it from both of us. He's got that just in tuned in. Plus, he just loves it himself. So, like I said, he's amazing. You know, he hasn't put a lot of stuff online. I don't think he really has put that much stuff. He's got this goofy little YouTube channel, but not that I'm making fun of it. I'm just saying he's got this YouTube channel, and he's got just a bunch of like him just messing around on there. But you ever heard him for real play? You'd be pretty amazed at his age already. Sorry, scratching my calf with my guitar pick. You know what guitar picks are great for? Cleaning the in between your teeth. I used to sit there all the time, just sit there and just dig out in between my teeth my guitar picks. So if you grab one of my guitar picks, you're like, did you clean your teeth with this? Yep. So just warning you, if you ever pick up one of my guitar picks, I probably cleaned my teeth with it or scratched myself with it. Sorry, Guitar Center. We have a whole bunch of these that ended up in pockets, so. These are the picks that I use. I don't know if I ever showed you my picks. I use a 1.5. This is for bass. I use a 1.5 millimeter, real thick. I use that for bass. And, you know, obviously, and I don't really, until I get the electric guitar, I don't really play with gun. I play like that with my acoustic. I mean, you can play chords on it. But, like I said, because I don't know, like, the full B, so I like that, right? And or like an F, or, which is, you know how you bar the F? I'm just playing these three strings, E, B, and high E, right? So why do I, all I need, the bar is those, I don't even need to keep the bar on it, I can just put my fingers on it like that, right? Sometimes I'll, even though it's a little off, if I'm only on it for a second, I'll play it off like that. Or sometimes I'll borrow it with my fingers. Depends on what I'm playing. And like, I'm not playing this note. No, never does my finger hit this for the most, unless I want to play that. But if I'm just going, you don't even really need to put your finger there. Just cover your G and cover your high G, and always, and ring that B. So with stuff, chords like, you know, like the F sharp, which you actually would want to bar it, or the C sharp. I find it just easier to do it. Like, I'll play for it real quick. I was trying to learn The Trees by Rush, and I was like, oh, I can't play a lot of those chords, but hey, I can play my fake chords, and it sounds pretty good. There is unrest in the forest, there is trouble with the trees. No, trees. Oh, the maples want more sunlight, and the oaks ignore the bleed. Is that how it goes? Yeah. Sorry. Unrest in the forest, there is trouble with the trees, but the maples want more sunlight, and the oaks ignore the plea. Stuff out of order. Give us light. No, light. For something. No, some. No, I got this screwed up. Let's do it right. Right. The trouble with the. No, trouble with the maples. Oh, yeah. Trouble with the maples. And they're quite convinced they're right. They say the oaks are just too lofty. There's no more old oppression. That's the end of the song. No more old oppression. No oppression. For they passed a noble law, and they won. They wonder why the maple something by accident. Oh, jeez. I totally butchered that. There is trouble in the forest, and the creatures all have fled, for the maples grow. I gotta look at the lyrics. That's the other thing, is I can never remember the lyrics. I forget the lyrics all the time. Let's do that real quick. I wanna close out on actually knowing how to play that stupid song, or at least playing, yeah, at least a somewhat butchered, instead of a completely butchered version of it. Here, I wrote it down here. Let's hope it doesn't mess up my keyboard there. Okay. Where are we at? There's unrest in the forest, the troubles of the trees. Okay, we got there. Well, let's do that. There is unrest in the forest, there is trouble with the trees. Oh, the maples want more sunlight, and the oaks ignore the plea. So let's go to the... So the trouble with the maples, and they're quite convinced they're right. They say the oaks are just too lofty, they grab up all the light. But the oaks can help their feelings if they light the way the main. And they wonder why the maples can't be happy in their shade. There is trouble in the forest, and the creatures all have fled. Oh, the maples scream oppression, and the oaks just shake their head.
Yeah, you get the point. Okay. Sorry.
I do that myself too. I'll try to play something and I can't figure it out and I just get irritated and it's like I gotta figure it out before I put the guitar down. Even if I'm gonna butcher it, I gotta do it. Yeah, I'm OCD that way. I can't. I'm restless and anxious unless I got something how I want it right before I put the guitar down. That's the way it works. So, does this make any sense? I mean, this whole thing, like I said, I know what you're doing and you're a real musician, you're probably like, this guy's out of his freaking mind. But that's how I think. So now you know, now you get a little bit of the sense of how I think when it comes to music. I'm kind of all over the place. I kind of, you know, let's try this, let's take this apart, let's do this, let's try to do this right, let's try to do this wrong, blah, 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 blah. And again, this is totally unscripted and totally unrehearsed. I mean, even though I kind of played some of these songs before, so you're getting, like, me a little nervous, too, and a little like, I gotta play in front of people? What are you talking about? So, so there's that, too. But outside of that, yeah, I mean, that's just the way I approach it. So again, you have any questions or you just want to tell me I suck and should quit, do that too. thing is, like I said, I'm not doing this for anybody's benefit but my own. So, you know, and if that's a crime, you know, they really think we're the devil, let's send them to hell. Remember, that's a great line from Blue Oyster Cult. yeah, so what are we working on? Or what's going to happen next? Yeah, we hit the hour, so... waiting for that Transformers the Movie soundtrack. I'm sure I'm probably going to dig into some of those songs and try to do some stuff. Again, I'll show you those Les Pauls at some point online here, what I was looking at, and I'll show you that. Look up that, while you're at it, just go and look up on eBay, look up the Ace Frehley signature guitar. It's a Chibson, Chinese Gibson. Look up that one. And then I think the other one's on AliExpress or whatever. They're about $300, $280 to $300, out of my price range. But they're cool. I mean, they got, like, the blue one's really slick looking. Well, I'm not a huge fan of a blue guitar, but that Ace Frehley blue one, that is pretty slick looking. So maybe in the next time we touch on a Kiss video, which hopefully will be soon, I'll go into some detail, or I'll show you guys that, and we'll kind of look at that together. I'd love to get one of those. It'd be great. But I don't think I can afford that. But the other one I'm looking for, the other knockoff, Les Paul, the Soteri Sunburst, it's like $170, somewhere around there. It's, you know, under $200. That's a little bit more my speed. Even that's a little pricey for me. I would rather get like a, you know, a Kataxin for like $80, $70, $80. They don't make those. This other company also does make an SG, another one of my favorite guitars, but I'm really got my mind set on that Cherry Burst Gibson Les Paul knockoff. I got my son's, he's got his Fender amplifier here, and I can even throw on, I can use the Zoom and just throw some distortion. He's got a fuzz, couple of, you know, distortion pedals on the Zoom, and play it, and just jam with some headphones on, which is probably what I'm going to do anyways. Learn this God of Thunder stuff, and there's a couple other ones I want to learn too. Hard Luck Woman, I want to learn some Hard Luck Woman on the acoustic, that'd be pretty fun. But, alright, so this is my kind of, I'll probably do more of these maybe as I think of them. They're nice little in-between filler video of, you just me screwing around, you know, and kind of just seeing how my thought process works. But this isn't unlike my drawing ability, because my drawing ability, you want to walk down a crazy road. Let me explain. And like I said, I'm a terrible teacher, so you're not going to. And again, as you can see watching this video, I'm not the best teacher. I can't really teach very well. I just, this. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about, right? No, you have no idea what I'm talking about. But I know what I'm talking about. At least I think I do. It makes sense in my mind, so therefore I just assume that you know. So that's the kind of, that's why I don't teach very well. Trying to teach art, too. Trying to teach what I do, I don't think I could do it. Because you'd just be like, what? You're like, I don't understand a word you're saying, right? But I like your art. But I can understand how you're explaining, because I'm all over the place. Trust me, I get all over all the different tangents when it comes to my art. So if I didn't scare you off, subscribe. If you like this video, again, and it wasn't total, you know, pain, the sound of boiling cats in water, then, you know, hit the like button. So, you know, and give me some feedback. You're like, well, no, don't do videos like that again, Tim. Imagine. Ixnay and the Itar play gay day bay, whatever, you know, or say, you know, what you said kind of interesting, and I kind of like that, you know, that's what I'm hoping you say, and you say, you know, and you go, oh yeah, and I'll be like, oh, wait, want to hear more of my insanity? All right, well, sure, I'll play some more of my insanity. So there you go. It is what it is. I don't know why I said that, but anyways, it is what it is. I'll catch you on the flip side. Talk to you then. Bye-bye.